your name?
I was on my way to San Francisco. I just won the Port and Civil Engineering assignment. Then I was on the water. There was a storm. A light in the distance. And God, the rest is just a blur. It's possible. It's maddening.
A wound in your head. I found you unconscious on the beach. You've been knocked out for 2 days. The light? It was a warning, not an invitation.
Thank you for looking after me. You're in your debt, Mr.
Let me be clear, boy. This place is isolated, remote. I like it that way. My job here is to maintain the house, the grounds, and to keep the light burning. It's not to play host to guests or nursemaid.
Of course. Now that I'm up and around, I won't impose on you any longer. I'll be on my way this afternoon.
No one leaves this peninsula.
Excuse me?
No one leaves this peninsula except by ferry.
When does it do?
2 weeks.
There must be another passage.
There is. A footpath.
And?
Impassable. Runoff from the mountains bloats the creek this time of year. Crossing it would be suicide.
You have a telephone. My shipwrecked. The authorities will know about it. Hello? Hello? There'll be ship manifest. A missing persons report. They can tell me who I am. Hello? Nothing.
The lines must be down after the storm. Happens all the time.
On the beach, did you find a satchel?
A satchel?
Yeah, with a manuscript inside.
You're a writer?
No. Well, yes, it's a technical journal. It's complicated.
My ambitions led me to the city once, to a lucrative position. But it didn't work out.
She must have taken it.
Who?
A girl. I saw her on the beach before I fell.
You didn't see a girl?
Yes, a young woman. I called out to her, but she didn't answer me. I followed her, but she disappeared behind the rocks.
She didn't answer you because there is no girl. You and I are the only two souls on this godforsaken rock. You're not in your right mind. Your imagination, it's playing tricks with you.
No, but I can't be sure of anything in my present state.
I have work to do. Walsh. My name is Walsh.
that. I want to talk to you.
Causes these tremors.
The cliff below us is chalk, riddled with catacombs, eroded by the crashing waves continuously when the tide comes in.
That's true. The foundation of this house will be compromised. It's only a matter of time.
Then let's drink to the lighthouse crumbling into the sea. Not a drinking man. Don't worry. I'm used to drinking alone.
Perhaps I can reinforce the foundation.
Stave off the inevitable?
It's the least I could do to repay your hospitality. After all, if I'm going to be a prisoner here, I might as well be useful.
Whatever you want.
I don't understand you. I tell you this house is bound to come around your ears and you just shrug.
Did you call it a prison? You've been here a few days. Imagine being here a lifetime. This peninsula, it's a grave. This lighthouse, tombstone. Forgive me if I fail to shed a tear at the prospect of its destruction.
Don't you care about anything?
I did once. I took a young wife. I promised her a prosperous new life in the city. Jobs were scarce. Finally, when I was desperate for work, I brought her here. Ours was a whirlwind courtship. She was so beautiful. So vibrant when we met. But it's hard to know a woman after so short a time. She became melancholy. For weeks on end, she would despair. I thought that starting a family would make her feel less alone, but she couldn't bear the thought of a child suffering here the way she did. Her constant sorrow began to annoy me. I just wanted to shake the sadness out of her.
What happened?
She made her escape.
The woman on the beach?
There is no woman. We are alone here.
No, I saw her again this afternoon in the woods. It was no hallucination. My mind was clear.
Is your mind clear now? Has your memory returned? Do you know who you are? Can you even tell me your real name?
How can you be so sure we're alone? How can you be sure I didn't see your wife?
Because I saw her fall into the sea. Let the burial rites be read. Let the funeral song be sung. An anthem to her, the queenliest dead, that ever died so young. A dirge for her, the doubly dead, in that she died so young. Let your cattle come out.
Always, always keep a light burning.
Morning. What do you have there?
Kerosene. The light needs to be refueled constantly.
Tell me, is there a safe way down to the beach?
The staircase. It's just a stone's throw from here. That way. If you'd waited till the tide went out that first day instead of foolishly scaling the cliff, it would have become obvious.
Hey, keep away from the caves. They're dangerous.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to frighten you. I don't mean you any harm.
I'm not the one about to suffer harm. Talk.
I was afraid you would disappear again before I had a chance to speak with you.
You should have shown yourself.
I've called to you before. You didn't answer. I've seen you twice before, and twice you disappeared without a word. I'm beginning to think you were a ghost.
Ow! What a ghost do that. Stand by the fire before you catch your breath. Someone's so desperate to speak with me. Don't say much.
Sorry. What's your name? What are you doing out here? Are you alone?
A lot of questions.
Sorry.
You say that a lot. My name is Nora. What's yours?
You can call me JP, I guess.
JP? What kind of name is that? What does it stand for?
I don't know. What do you think?
No, I was being mysterious.
Never answered my question. What are you doing living alone, out here of all places?
Times are tough all over. It's no secret. Not this place would be. Refuge, I guess. It'd be dangerous. Out there forever all alone.
Somehow I think you can handle yourself.
Why are you looking at me like that, JP?
Have we met? I feel like I know you.
I bet you say that to all the girls.
Haven't you ever felt that way about someone you've just met?
Once. A long time ago.
Tell me, is there another way off this peninsula, other than by ferry?
That depends.
On what?
On how strong a swimmer you are.
I can't swim. Do I see you again?
You know the way now, don't you?
Do you have to go? Come with me back to the lighthouse. At least for a little while before you return.
No, I can't.
I don't understand.
Don't speak of me, Walsh.
Don't speak of you.
Please, JP. It's mad.
Nora, wait!
What are you doing?
Did you hear that?
voices. What were they telling you?
I don't know. It wasn't quite clear. More of a low murmur.
Like wind? Like the creaking of an old house settling? Like the sounds of an old lighthouse on unstable ground?
You think I dreamed it? Perhaps.
Who is this? The woman you spoke of?
No. It's just a drawing. You're right, there is no girl. She's just a figment of my imagination, or a ghost.
I don't believe in ghosts.
You don't believe in the afterlife.
I've lived through hell and heaven here on Earth, usually by my own design. Nothing awaits me after death except the cold embrace of the grave.
It's a pretty somber outlook.
You're still young, boy. Wait until you get to my age. You might find the promise of oblivion, a reprieve. This is my private room. Keep out. I will not warn you again.
Thank you.
Nora.
Come with me.
Where?
I want to show you something.
What is it?
Come on.
I warn you, don't let this go out again.
Nora. What are you doing here? Do you want Walsh to see you?
No. But I couldn't stay away. I had to see you. You hardly know me.
I know you. Nora!
a dream, isn't it? As a child, I used to dream of a little boy. And I pinched myself to wake up because I couldn't bear the thought of falling in love with someone. It was just a figment of my imagination. It was so like you. When I first saw you on the beach, I thought I was dreaming.
I felt the same way. Like I jumped you before we met.
I'm afraid.
Of what?
Being alone again.
This isn't a dream. It's real. Lately, my mind has been like a book with shuffled pages, but I'm sure about one thing. Come with me.
What?
Come with me to San Francisco.
No one leaves this peninsula.
Nonsense. Where'd you hear that, Welsh? Nora, this sadness, it isn't like you.
We're all of us more than one person, JP.
I am leaving. And I'm asking you to come with me to San Francisco. We can build a life there.
Is it possible?
Yes.
Yes. Yes, take me with you.
I will.
We'll be together.
Always.
Thank you.
George. Please, JP. He's mad.
No one leaves this peninsula. No one leaves this peninsula.
She was desperate. You filled her head with lies, made her think she couldn't leave this place.
I don't know what you're talking about. We're here alone.
How long have I been here? When's the ferry coming? When's it coming? Tell me.
2 weeks.
What ferry will be here in 2 weeks?
No.
You said that before. I want the truth.
Silent. The love of God.
Stop! Voices. You do hear them.
No.
Don't lie to me.
All right. All right! Yes. Yes, I hear the voices. Whispering. Angry. Vengeful. Whispering! They torment me. Torment me.
Open the door.
Thank you.
damn you!
Put his bony hand around your throat and choke the life out of you. Why are you standing there? Go to the kitchen. Go to the back. Light all of the candles. They are ball light. Go! To let down our guard until the morning sun drives them back into the shadows.
You saved me back there. Thank you.
That was twice, boy.
That's for striking me on the beach when my back was turned.
I probably saved your life. You should know by now that nobody leaves this peninsula.
You've said that before. You know exactly what's going on here. What are those things?
They are my curse, my plague, spawn of the destroyer, born of the sepulchre, to torment me, drag me back to hell. Vengeance. That is what they want. Plain and simple.
You're wrong, then.
Yes.
And you know how to appease them.
I cannot change what I have done. Nothing less than my soul will sate their hunger.
What did you do? Tell me.
My wife fell. I wanted to die, but I was too cowardly to finish myself. I would drink until I couldn't lift the glass. Then one night, I failed to refuel the lamp. I'd let the light go out many times in my drunken stupor, but this time the ship suffered the consequences. A tramp steamer. I saw it approaching, and I
I tried to light the signal, but I was too late. I stood there and watched as it crashed on the rocks. There were no survivors.
You hid them. Buried them in those catacombs.
Broke into 100 pieces. Sank beneath the waves. What little of it washed up on shore I burned. Most of the men went down with the ruined hulk. Those that tried to swim to shore, they never made it. They drowned. Their bodies dashed on the rocks. In 1 or 2 days, there was no trace that it ever happened. I could almost convince myself it was a bad dream. Almost.
You bastard. Those men had wives. Families. They deserve to know.
I could imagine that woman on the widow's walk. I could see her on the roof of her house, looking out across the horizon, waiting for her husband to return from the sea. I thought about all those sailors' children. Lost at sea has a much nicer ring to it than dead. They could still hope that way. I could not take that from them.
You hear yourself. You're inhuman.
I'm only human. I did what any man would have done under the circumstances.
Not every man.
You think you would have done something differently?
I know I would have.
You know nothing. You don't know who you are until you face the horror yourself.
Thank you.
understand.
What's not to understand? Take me with you to San Francisco.
I'm sorry. I can't do that.
Why not?
The ferry hasn't come.
Well, then I have a better idea. You can stay with me here. Forever.
No!
Thank you.
Yes. I didn't know who I was before, but I do now. I do now.
Is that so?
Yeah. You were wrong about one thing, though.
What was that?
Those things out there. I believe they can be appeased.
How do you propose to do that?
I'm going to kill you, Lighthouse Keeper.
Thank you. Oh.